Yes, you are connected, so feel free to begin.
Excellences, ladies and gentlemen, colleagues and OGP friends, a very warm hello to you all, and thank you for this opportunity to participate in the 7th OGP Global Summit. My name is Veronica Crețu. I'm an OGP envoy and the co-chair of the Moldovan Open Government Coordination Committee. And I'm thrilled to be here today with the Prime Minister of the Republic of Moldova, Ms. Natalia Gavrilița. Thank you for being with us, Prime Minister Gavrilița. And I think both of us here are together for a number of good reasons. We are here because Moldova, which proudly joined the OGP in April 2012, was indeed a front runner and has been successfully implementing 4 national action plans up to date. We are here today because we were able as a country to share our knowledge, host study visits in Moldova, train and capacitate peers from government, civil society in the region on issues such as open data, transparency in decision making, citizen engagement, governance reform scorecards, open contracting, beneficial ownership, to name just a few. However, our open government journey has been a roller coaster, and we are also here today because in addition to our success stories, we have failed, particularly when we lacked genuine high-level commitment for open government. We also failed when our civic space was under threat and was vulnerable. Nonetheless, we never gave up on our OGP mandate and membership. In moving towards the next decade of OGP, we want to see ambitious reforms in the justice sector and the rule of law, integrity and innovation across public administration, radical transparency, why not, and accountability. And we want to see tangible results and move from paper and declarations to implementation. We want to really explore the full potential of the OGP for the governance processes in Moldova. And in doing so, we want to work hand in hand with your government. Prime Minister Gavrilița, your government has come to power in very complicated, sensitive times for our country. It has come to power on the promise of reform. What do you think can be the role of open government approaches, principles and values, and the OGP platform overall for the implementation of the reforms of your government? And thank you once again for joining us today.
Thank you, Veronica, and ladies and gentlemen, it is a pleasure to be here and to greet you at this 7th OGP Global Summit. Indeed, transparency and accountability represent key commitments of the new government of Moldova. We have been in power for just over 4 months, and we were elected with a strong mandate to fight corruption and to replace the informal governance system with good governance. Therefore, some of the measures that have already been taken by the government targeted public procurement schemes, which had eluded precisely these principles of transparency and accountability. It is our firm commitment to reintroduce the rule of law, as Veronica already mentioned. Also, then this involves enhancing the accountability of judges and prosecutors. And now we are in the process of drafting and passing legislation that will introduce external vetting of judges and prosecutors. And I want to mention the fact that this is precisely in line with a recommendation formulated in the Moldova Design Report 2019-2020 of the independent reporting mechanism of the Open Government Partnership. We also place professional ethics and integrity at the heart of our approaches within public administration. And in this regard, I welcome the fact that Moldova is one of the countries targeted by the EU for integrity program for the Eastern Partnership, which is jointly implemented by OGP and the OECD Anti-Corruption Network for Eastern Europe and Central Asia. I also want to mention digitalization. This is one of the main priorities of my government, precisely because digital solutions enhance transparency and are also an excellent tool to mitigate the risk of corruption. Our guiding principle is that in public administration, especially in the relationship with citizens, businesses, and civil society, digital solutions should become the norm rather than the exception. The first steps that we have taken in this regard is to appoint a deputy prime minister responsible exclusively for digitalization and transsectoral coordination in this regard. But also, we already adopted a first legal package aimed at easing the interaction with public institutions online. It aims to create a single shop for certain services delivered to citizens and businesses in their interaction with the state, and canceled the burdensome need of asking for different paper-based documents, which often become a source of corruption. And finally, in the context of our discussion, I want to underscore that the Republic of Moldova is one of the few countries in the world in which cabinet meetings are broadcasted live online, and after an initial firefighting period and some crises that we had to overcome, we have now established the rule of transparency in decision making, and all acts of the government are published the week before they are adopted, with a consultation period ahead of time.
Thank you, Prime Minister, and thank you for listing those ambitious and hopefully transformational actions and initiatives. And because you mentioned consultations, let me quickly pick up on the role of civil society and get your views on the role that civil society can play in Moldova's journey towards this ambitious reform agenda. And how can civil society and your government work better together under this new political context, but also making sure that your government is being held accountable to its people?
Indeed, transparency and accountability also involves engagement and dialogue with the civil society, which is also needed because the government welcomes and needs the expertise of NGOs, which can compensate the institutional weaknesses and lack of capacities in state institutions. I'm proud to say that some of the ministers in my cabinet come from prominent civil society organizations. We are also now in the process of reviewing and updating the National Strategy for Sustainable Development, Moldova 2030, and public servants and members of my team are working closely together with leading experts from civil society on this important project. This reflects a broader approach that we have for pooling expertise actively in my team, as well as in other ministries. Consultants provided by civil societies and international organizations are working alongside state employees to ensure the best possible policy proposals. I would also like to highlight that all the measures that have been taken in the context of the COVID crisis and the new COVID wave that we faced in October, November of this year were first consulted with the representatives of the sectors that were most affected by pandemic regulations. And through this, we replaced this top-down approach of previous governments with an approach based on dialogue aimed at finding the best solution. Even now, we are in the process of consulting the appropriate measures in the current circumstances and ahead of the winter holidays. And one further priority that I would like to mention is our engagement with the diaspora, which is also part, an important part of the Moldovan civil society. These are people with hands-on experience in companies or organizations in Western countries who can support the government with expertise and best practices, but also they can become agents of change. They can help us improve the governance of state-owned enterprises, for example, or the governance of state institutions. And we are preparing a program for stimulating the return of diaspora and facilitating the reintegration of citizens of the Republic of Moldova. Thank you very much for this opportunity.
Thank you. Thank you very much, Prime Minister. You mentioned diaspora, you mentioned preeminent CSOs. I just want to highlight that on the civil society side, we want to reiterate the importance of more holistic and inclusive approach to civil society engagement. And I hope as we move towards the co-creation of our fifth action plan on open government, early next year, together with your government, we can bring in those different perspectives. And why not reposition Moldova as a front runner in the OGP? Let's aim for this. With this, thank you so much, Prime Minister, for joining us, for being with us today. Thank you, South Korea. Thank you, OGP, and everyone, wishing you a fantastic summit. Thank you.
We will work together towards this aim. And thank you for the opportunity to speak in front of the seventh OGP summit. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. Thank you for your valuable time and